Con le ascelle pezzate, tra l'altro.
I came from Lake Maggiore. Ovviamente non lo metti, se no sulla band.
Lo metto di brutto con le ascelle che si vede.
No, no.
Ancora, ci puoi scommettere che lo metto.
Allora io me ne vado. Minchia, Fede, la tua carbonara spacca. Ma così è cringe. Hai fatto una buona carbonara, comunque.
So.
Se ci mettevi un po' di latte di soia, era buona. Più buona. Never skip leg day.
A lot of people are very curious to know the process behind the songwriting, to know the details, how it happened. I mean, step by step, how is stuff done?
You want to start?
Yes, basically there is the idea for the melody, for the main vocal line of the song that goes toe to toe with the guitar parts, the basis of the guitar parts that then will be developed. And then I think that it's Niso time to come and play.
For what concerns Winterbane songwriting process, I have to say that it's a mechanical way for every song. In fact, the method me and Federico used was that he sent me the demo of the song, I listened to it and I started to think of what can be as functional as possible. Then maybe with some WhatsApp vocal audio I made Federico aware of what I'm thinking to do, and then I write down the first definitive version. Federico heard the version and maybe could tell me what was wrong, maybe something didn't fit so well with the voices, because sometimes I worked only with a guitar lead that reminds of the vocal lines.
Ci sta, ci sta.
Swimming like hell. No, non si dice così. No, questa non la dico.
La metto di brutto. Anzi, la metto 3000 volte che si ripete.
Swimming like
hell. Guarda, vedrai. You'll see.
So usually when we are composing a song, creating a song, after the vocal lines and the guitar melodies, we have to put a really, really basic drum rhythm. You know, something just to give the direction to the song, to let me sing it properly when I am, yes, you know, developing the vocal lines. Yes. So usually...
Everyone does it.
Yes, usually we send to you this kind of song with a very, very simple yes, drum line, but this didn't happen for Blood on the Snow.
Yes, because these really basic drum lines allowed me to make an idea. And Blood on the Snow, it was completely different, because Federico sent me the files without any drums line under the guitar, because all the songs are guitar based in Winterbane, but also in chi se ne frega. I received the guitar lines, rhythmic guitar and guitar lead, the drum, as we said before, the drum lines, MIDI drum lines, and the BPM. The information for the drummer, the most important information is the BPM.
So there were no vocal lines?
No, yes, there were no vocal lines, maybe submerged in the mix, very raw materials to work with. After I write down and I played on the demo, I develop the general sound of the song. Federico told me two times, just little corrections to make, and then I said, okay, that's the definitive version, no more mistakes. No second thoughts.
Innanzitutto, first of all, how old were you when you entered Frozen Crown? Don't lie.
17, but almost 18. It was almost 18.
No, because I don't know why, but he doesn't like to say he was 17.
No, 17, but almost 18.
Ah, beh, allora.
Allora cambia.
Sì. Sì. So, we wrote an album, yes, in quarantine without ever watching each other. I mean, we never met before. So, how did you leave this songwriting process?
From the beginning, the communication between you and I was very fluid and nice, so I find myself good with you, mm-hmm, in writing the album and the song, the drum lines. When you sent me the demos, I listened them a lot, so when I decided to start writing the part, I was in a very good feeling with you already.
Meno male.
Yes, because we were writing from a lot of time. So. Yeah,
maybe we had some cold too.
Yes, some cold, but not too much. Then when we started to write down, maybe for the arrangements, I came up with some ideas. In that case, we called each other.
Before starting talking about songs in detail, we talked a lot. I remember also about philosophy, or maybe maybe also about other topics like musical tastes.
Yes, artistic. Also our personality and to know the person who you are working with.
It's very different to work like that, or maybe you feel like we did a good job even if we weren't able to see each other.
Yes, you can see someone and analyze the attitude, the most important thing. But anyway, I had the opportunity to know better your mental attitude, and I was curious to know you in person.
This is maybe a philosophical question.
Yes.
Do you think you...
I'm ready.
You were able maybe to know something about me by just listening to those songs? I mean, through the music I was writing, or do you think maybe...
By the essence of music, yes, because the music you write represent yourself.
Ah,
yes.
Bellissima questa cosa, explain it, please.
I think the minimalism behind your composition reflect on your personality and your straightforward mental set. I don't know how to explain better than this.
No, that's interesting. Che tutto a posto, siamo bene?
Sì, siete proprio belli.
Yes, but when I met you, it was different, more in the depth of the situation.
But did you have surprises, or were you able to identify me already with my music and my phone calls only?
I was positively surprised.
Ah!
But not in all, because I thought that you were a smoker.
A smoker?
Yes.
But a smoker of what?
Cigarette smoker.
And why? Why a smoker?
I don't know. Sai cosa? Non è che pensavo che fumassi. Mi sono chiesto se fumavi. Mi sono immaginato te che fumavi. Ho detto ci può stare, ci sta.
Ci sta.
Però in realtà nella tua, cioè, ci sta che non fumi dopo che ti ho conosciuto. Questo è stato il pensiero.
Perché non fumo?
Perché no? Perché dovresti?
Bravo. The lockdown and the distance didn't impact too much on our relationship, you know, on our songwriting process.
On our songwriting process, no, because there weren't any other methods to communicate, and thanks to the technologies of our time, it works so well.
Sì. You felt like you had to adapt, or was it natural to you?
Kinda. No, da Italia.
Kind of,
sì, però aspetta. Both of them. Natural, because I had other experience to send files and working with other people in the first lockdown.
Mm-hmm.
I had to adapt my feeling concerning your attitude behind the songwriting process. Ci sta, ci sta.
Beh, diccelo in inglese, però.
In inglese, come si dice ci sta?
It stays.
Non sarà mai così, ma... Acqua e caffè. Dillo in...
Cosa?
Acqua e caffè.
Che devo dire acqua e caffè?
Caffè.
Perché tu come dici?
Caffè. No, non è vero.
Caffè, ma che è?
E tu dici doccia.
Io dico doccia.
Ah, è vero, non è vero che dicevi doccia.
No, io dico doccia.
Questo è già nel musical talk.
Questo è già un talk, ma infatti è già divertente a dirla tutta, se proprio devo essere sincero. Ci sta. We received a ton, really a lot of positive reactions to the new album and to your drumming. So a lot of people made compliments to you, no? I have a theory that if you make things under pressure and in difficult conditions, you are doing better things than usual. What do you think about this?
I think that's true, because in the process of making something, you have to think about all the details and everything. So just takes the time that it takes, not more, not less.
Yes.
I think that, by the way, it's important to have your relax and all under control.
If you don't have a limit, if you have all the time of this world, it's harder to actually create something, because you can always try to make it better and better and better, and you never finish it.
Yes, perfectionism. extremely exaggerated things are never the best.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you are an obsessed person and all the things must be perfect, every time you listen to your song you notice something that could be better. I think it's a better sensation when you listen to your old thing and you say, here I could insert something different. But then you realize that that was a photography of that moment
of that
your life. So when you're recording, when you're also in the writing process and the stylistic arrangement, it's a photography of yourself.
I totally disagree with everything they said so far. For me, it's the opposite. I don't give my best under pressure. I prefer to have a little bit more time because I know where to stop. I know how to recognize that the thing I did was the best and I'm satisfied with that. I'm not a person that goes in the loop in an infinite spiral of perfectionism.
It's up to you. If you are your kind of person.
You are never going to have time because you're working with us, so.
Yes, that's you know, my anguish, but while they were explaining their points of view, you know, I was boiling here in my seat waiting for my moment to say, I disagree and don't give my best under pressure.
But you will have to do that.
While we were filming this video, Niso talked about so many interesting things about drumming, about the rhythm, and about his rhythmical approach to music and to Frozen Crown songs that were so interesting, we actually thought about splitting this video in two parts and show you all of that later in a second video completely focused on drumming. Here's a little preview for you. Let us know in a comment how much we would like to see this video. See you next time!
If the song is a very linear one, you cannot put your drum nerd thing on that.
We Frozen Crown are number one supporters of this approach.
Because we want to sell stuff, we want to sell albums.
Yes.
Money! Adesso non vedi?
Farli cadere un po' più spolverati, capito? You have to wait the right moment to express your skills, because also had the right intention to make a functional drum line is a skill. If you want to hear me swagging, you can follow me on Instagram.
Swagging?
E qua mi è tesori!